Now, another thing in the, as I was thinking about preparing this talk for startup companies is, since I'm a big company guy and most of the people in the audience have worked at one point in time for large companies, you think about what large companies do. So the classic prescription for managing in a downturn from a large company is, number one, to manage your cash flow, cutting headcount, cutting capex, postponing major projects, that type of thing. The second thing is to secure backlog. You've got to have secure your revenue over the next couple of years throughout the downturn. There's a variety of different ways to do that. First and foremost, of course, is aggressive sales and marketing. Secondly, is you start bundling services. During an upturn in a large integrated service company, for example, the product lines will differentiate from each other and move away from each other because some product lines might have more room to raise prices in an upcycle than others. And so they will move away. Well, in a downturn, to secure backlog, bundling all the product lines together or the services together is an effective mechanism to secure significant backlog. Obviously, many of the large service companies will focus on national oil companies, and the reason for that is obvious. They're less likely to be cutting their capital budgets severely. And something large companies will do is to leverage their new technologies. If they've got a new technology coming out of product development and getting launched, they will use that as the tip of the spear for their bundling strategy. But it's absolutely critical to secure a backlog. Then you'll obviously come up on the struggles of price versus share and how to balance that during a downturn. And no matter what the executives say in a service company, they say, we'll defend our price, our prices are sacrosanct, this is what it costs, it's expensive, there's a new baseline for costs. They will defend price as long as possible, and it's entirely appropriate. They'll begin to stack assets to reduce capacity, such as ships, drilling rigs, tool sets, etc. When the time comes, however, they will lead the prices down. If they start losing too much market share, large companies will lead prices down if they're the market leader, because otherwise, to do otherwise, they will lose significant market share. Now, here's where this red line here is very interesting. There's a fourth tactic, and this is this red line separates the men from the boys here, because only the strong companies can do what's below the line here, and that's roll out new technology, maintain or increase R&D activity, and continue to recruit. Now, I'll grant you that in many of the large companies, the R&D activity will shift from a capital R and a capital D to perhaps a small R and a small D and a big engineering component. So there'll be a little bit of a shift, but they can keep going with this kind of activity, whereas a less strong company will have to perhaps take the difficult choice to slash R&D. So this is really what I would call counter-cyclical investment, and it's a key component of an important strategy. But you have to be strong enough during the good years, set aside cash in order to be able to do it.